Hi, my name is Margie Igoli, and I'm a faculty member here at Kent State Salem campus in the Radiologic Technology program. As in any programs, we employ all three learning domains here. The first domain is the cognitive domain. Obviously, what we do here is we have the classes on the campus, and we will test you out of textbook kind of information. The next domain that we would employ would be the psychomotor domain. With that domain, what we need to do is have the skills to move the equipment and operate the equipment to get our images. We can do that both here clinically at the campus, and then obviously the students will go out to their clinical education site and employ that psychomotor domain when they're working with the equipment there. The last domain, which I feel is really important when you're working in healthcare, is the affective domain. Affective domain deals with the emotions. We really truly hope that when you come into this program, before you come in, you are a compassionate, caring, kind, and loving person, because that's what it takes to help work with people in healthcare. We will employ those affective domains, and we will talk about that a lot with the different types of cases that you'll have at your clinical site. The other thing I would like to mention is that this position is just amazing because there's so many ways that you can advance. The technology is constantly advancing, and there are various places of employment. You can be employed at a hospital. We have some sites that are level one trauma centers, as well as some sites that are more of a smaller community-based hospital. You can also work mobily. You can go out to places. You can be a traveling technologist if you'd like. You can even go into sales and education in the field if that's where your life would lead you. The other thing that we're very proud of here at our campus is that both the associate and the bachelor's degree programs have an extremely high passing rate for their national certification. This is important because if you spend 2 to 4 years developing and training and practicing your craft and you can't pass that national certification, you can't practice in the field. So we are very strict with our grades, and we are very proud of that near 100% passing rate. If we look at some of the images that you might take, the general radiography, we deal a lot with broken bones. This is the tibia and fibula. We can see a lateral view of the broken leg. A most common examination we're going to do is a chest x-ray. And then also we deal with some contrast, in which we either have the patient ingest or we will insert some contrast into their system. And this is a barium enema that we might perform. On the lower half of the bank there, we have our specialty programs. We have CT, and this is a cross-sectional of the CT of the head. And then we also have an abdomen, a cross-sectional, where we can see the vertebrae and the kidneys. And then we can go into MRI, and this is a coronal plane looking at, I'm sorry, not coronal, this is a sagittal plane looking at the brain and the brainstem. And lastly there, we have sonography, which uses sound waves to produce its images. The last thing I'd really like to tell you is that this career is something because it's exciting, it's ever-changing, and more importantly, you can affect people's lives daily by just being there, smiling, helping them, and getting the images so that they can get a good diagnosis and hopefully a treatable outcome. Thank you.